people died on I-10 near Lordsburg, New Mexico.
Found a seventh body in the crash caused by a dust storm in southern New Mexico.
Brownout conditions can happen in an instant, making the roads disappear. New Mexico Department of Transportation says for drivers to take extra caution.
In 2014, the amount of lives lost and the dangers presented by the dust storms really elevated the issue of the Lordsburg Playa dust storms for the DOT especially. We started going back and looking at the crash numbers and seeing that there had been quite a few fatalities and a lot of accidents that had happened in this area. But a 25 square mile playa is a daunting physical environment to set up any sort of monitoring equipment. And what do you use to monitor dust? We needed more research, so we reached out to New Mexico State University and state climatologist Dave Dubois.
Hey Dave.
The New Mexico Department of Transportation said we're looking at dust storms in the Southwest. We came up with some ideas, and I started thinking about what are the meteorological drivers for these dust storms, what brings dust off the ground, how fast do things evolve, and how long do they go, and how bad is it? CLIMAS is a climate assessment of the Southwest, and it's a two-state RISA program between Arizona and New Mexico. They have social scientists that we don't have access to here in my university. So it brings in lots of networks, and the National Weather Service is a key partner in this project.
This is the weather forecast office for the El Paso area and southern New Mexico area. Our mission is to provide forecasts and warning information for any kind of inclement weather we have in the area.
Hey Dave, how's it going?
Dave Dubois and I keep in regular contact. We do a lot of information exchange back and forth.
We come to the table addressing a problem, and then we bring in science, and they bring in operations, and we mix them together.
They've planted sensors, video cameras, and observation sites all around the study area, which is the Lordsburg Playa, to try to get a measure of all of the different factors going into creating the dust events there.
When we start to see the large thunderstorms develop in certain areas, if they start to decay, you get these thunderstorm outflows. And that's one of the triggers for these dust storms is the outflow winds. So it's giving that information to them. And then they could decide on how to get that back out to the public.
I'm tracking an outflow boundary right here. The better we understand the particulars of the areas that are very prone to dust, the better we can alert the public and alert New Mexico Department of Transportation to provide much advanced warning as we can.
Our job in the collective sense at DOTs and Department of Public Safety and CLIMAS and everybody else who's attached to this is letting people know what should they do if they come across these dust storms.
Anytime that we have any sort of weather event, Dave provides us with the most recent data from information that came out on the playa.
See this spot right here.
Through this, we were quickly able to build up a level of knowledge about dangers in the area and the frequency of dust storms. In the past 6 months, the DOT has expanded the shoulders, increased the amount of digital message boards, both warning about dust storms and also what to do during a dust storm. So far, since we implemented these techniques, anytime there are dust events going on, people now can't ignore the fact that they are driving into a dust storm.
Part of our research over the past several years, we've really learned the behavior of these dust storms.
And we'll measure the mass here.
We have seen improvements. We certainly have a higher awareness. Certain wind events where we wouldn't consider those winds significant, we now know they are significant for certain portions of the playa depending on the direction. And we can apply that to our forecast process.
Our primary hope is that we're going to greatly reduce the amount of visibility, dust storm-related accidents and fatalities. But because of the vastness of the area and the difficulty of the problem, it's going to take a long-term commitment to be able to come to a long-term solution.
We're always going to be in a desert, and we're always going to have this issue going on. How do we work together as teams, as federal organizations, state organizations, tribes? That's the beauty of working with a RISA program, is kind of peeling off different knowledge, skills from other groups. And if we collaborate, leverage each other's work, as time goes on, we'll see a decrease in the number of accidents and decrease in the number of fatal accidents.